Hi everyone, this is me, Gleb, and this is Data Science Exercises. Today I want to kind of summarize previous episodes, yes, and I call it top four tool for data analysis, okay? So, and to demonstrate this top four tools, yes, for me it's just extensive set of tools. You can complete whatever you want with these tools, okay? So after watching this video, you don't need to learn anything. You can stop learning after this, okay? And I can stop teaching because nothing more could be said about like data analysis, you know? So I will demonstrate these tools on a German created data set. That's the open data set, very famous one. Yes, so very old one. So that's the banking data about customer who default or not default, you know, that's it. So you could find it on Kaggle, on this like old repository or for data. Here is the Kaggle page, okay? But and you also can skip finding the data, yes, and use my data, yes, because for you I have prepared it. And by the way, here is also the very smart way to import your data from Google Sheet. So here is the link to Google Sheet. So, and here is the data, yes, it's just in a table format, in a spreadsheet format. And it turns out that pandas can read this data just right from HTTP, you see? So here is the PD read CSV, can use HTTP address, just URL, you know? So the only thing you need to do is to extract the ID, this scary looking hash from this link, from this URL. And you can do it really simple because this, in Python, you can use a split function, yeah, to do it like this. So here is the URL splitted into like whatever number of parts it has like between the slash, okay? So, and I have this and at the position of 5, okay? So that's it. So that's how it's just to avoid manually copying it, yes? But nothing wrong with copying it manually, okay? So here, I just downloaded this data into Colab from Google to Google, you know? That's cool. So here is the data. And the first tool which solve 90% of your problems is a pivot table. That's it. And there is a function pivot table, but never use it, okay? You can watch the details about pivot table in my pivot table video, okay? To do pivot table, always use group by. It's much more convenient. Group by, let's say I want to build a pivot for housing column and see the default rate. How can I do it? Easy. Df group by housing, here is default, and here is I use ag function, and here I always want counts and I always want mean or median. For calculating rate, I use of course mean, yeah? So here is the pivot table. That's it. This tool solves most of your problem, okay? So, but pivot table loves another function from pandas, pdcut, yes? Because if you want to construct a pivot table for say credit amount, yes, and it is a continuous value, yes, it like not the like finite number of categories here, yes, it's a continuous number. So here, you will get an unreadable pivot table. Yes, it's too long to understand. Okay, so and you want to bin this variable into some intervals, and the best way to do it is using pdcuts. So I create a pdf amount bin equals pd cut. Here is df credit amount, and here, for example, I want 5 intervals. And now, instead of using the original variable, I will use this one, the new one, the bins, you know. So your variable now pivot table is readable, but the groups here, yes, they are not equal in terms of account, but they are equal in terms of length of the interval. So pdcut cuts the variable into equal intervals by its length, you know, but not by count. If you want to have equal count in each group, equal number of people, you just use the brother or a sister, I don't know, of pdcut. That's the ku cut, you know, and ku, that's from quantile, okay? Cool. And here is the beautiful groups of equal amount of people. So that's because the data set is small. Yes, so here is the groups is a little bit not equal. That's totally okay, you see. So that's how you use a pivot table, okay? That's the tool number one. Yes, by the way, if you like hardcore, you can like use only pivot table. That's it. Okay. So the next tool is plot, because sometimes it's hard to read the long pivot table. For example, if I introduce, let's say, 10 columns, 10 bins. It's hard to understand. Yes, it's hard to see a pattern here, you know. So to reveal the pattern, you could use a plot, the graph, a chart. So, and the most simple way to do it is just copy a pivot table. And instead of having these two variables, you could use mean, just one, yeah? And here is the plot. So there is no labels on an x-axis. Yes, you can solve this problem by switching the kind to a bar. Here's all categories are now labeled, okay? All bins, and you can understand, and you could see that like for the small amounts the default rate is high, then for a medium amounts it's kind of a little bit lower, and then on a big amounts it's high again. Okay, so that's kind of non-linear pattern here, but I prefer to use just line. You know, for me it's like kind of more readable sometimes, and it's more minimalistic, because if you open the math book or physics book, yes, you'll never find some fancy graphs here. Yes, it's most of the time it's just a line plot. That's it. Yes, so very rarely it's a bar chart. Yes, or something like that, and never pie chart, never violin chart. You know. So here the only fix for line could be the fixing the y-axis, y-lim equals 0 and 1, for example, if I want it from 0 to 1, you see? Oh, no, like this, from 0 to 1. And I see, now I could see that the drama here is not that big as I have seen on a bar chart, you see? So the like deviations between different bins in terms of default rate is not that high kind equals bar. Okay. So that's the two, that was the tool number two. It's a plot, just a plain vanilla plot without any parameters. Yes, it could help you most of the time. And if you like want to have it a little bit more fancy, yes, use kind bar. Next stuff is histogram. And histogram, you could find it in many of mathematical books, especially in statistics book. Yes, sometimes in some other mathematical book. So histogram can help you to understand the form, the shape of distribution. Let's see about again at credit amount hist. Yes. So here is the histogram where we could understand the how many people sits in each credit amount. So most of the people sits in a small credit amount, yeah, and then like in a medium it's a little bit less, and the huge credits have very few people. Okay, so that's how you can understand the form of the distribution. Sometimes the instead of using hist, people use box plot, but I don't like it, box plot, because for not symmetric distribution, it's not very good. Box plot, here is the column, let's say credit amount again, yeah. That's absolutely same information as we have here on a histogram, yes. So, but it is like if histogram is horizontal, the box plot is kind of histogram which has been turned 90 degrees like this. You see. So we have here the most data concentrated closer to zero, and here we can see the median, the green line, and here we could see the outliers. Yes, but I don't know why. You could read about how box plot kind of identifies outliers, but it could be confusing. You should not treat these points as outliers if box plot tells you so, you know. Don't listen to box plot. But box plot sometimes convenient to compare some variable between groups. So here you could use credit amount, and let's say use this variable housing. And so now you see on one plot the credit amount for three different groups, for free, own, and rent. That's, I don't know what means free, means live in a street, I don't know. So here we could see that credit amounts for free is higher than the median. Yes, that's important. The median for free category in housing is higher for median is higher. That's how you can compare the distributions by group. And by the way, you could do same thing by for a histogram like this. Just change it hist, and you can now analyze these three different histograms for each category. Yeah, but I think that if you can present something with table, do it using table. Do not plot any graphical data. So in this case, much better is to just represent your data using pivot table again. Yes, so here, like this, instead of here having the default, let's have credit amount, and instead of mean, let's have a median. Median, like this. Oops, credit amount. So for me, this information, this table, much more like informative than this plot, because I could see that, okay, here is the high median, yes, and here is the low median, that's it. So the table is always better than a picture. That's my rules of life, you know. And by the way, I always print counts because group size is very important. Yes, if group is small, it's probably this information is just noise, you know. And you may want to, as I shown you here, this line chart. Yes, if you came from Excel world, you may want to have like counts on the same plot here. Yes, and it is possible with pandas, but it's a bit tricky, and I personally do not use it very often. But today, yes, today is a very special day for you. I will show you how to do it. So here is the you can Google it, yes, how to plot pandas with a 2 y-axis. And here is the perfect answer, a simpler solution without PLT, because I personally hate matplotlib, yes, and I absolutely hate to import something extra in my code, yes. So I don't like to import this PLT, and I see that some people shares my feeling about it, okay. And so here the code how you can plot chart with 2 y-axis. Let me show you real quick. So here I want to have the median as a line chart and the counts as a bars underneath. So first of all, I have to save this table to a variable. So you see, it's like it's already too much hassle. Yes, saving table. Yes, so I never save my table, you know. I'm too cool for that. Here is the, let's go back. I should copy these 4 lines. 4 lines. So here is first one, T, and I want to have the median plot, yeah. Then I introduce the second axis, and then I plot the second set of data, the counts on this new axis, like this. Let's see if it worked. So here is the perfect, absolutely perfect chart, you see. But the only thing you have to do is to kind equals bar, and that should fix the problem, yeah. And also to make them a little bit more transparent, you can do it like this. Alpha equals 0.2, for example. It's just to make them transparent, you see. And here the median, I want it to be started from 0. Y lim equals 0, that's it. And so now I have my plot. And by the way, maybe it's better to have from 0 to here, to 5,000, like this. That's my chart. And here I could see that this group 3 is probably is too small to make a conclusion using it. It's only like about 100 people. Yeah, so not probably a good idea to use it. Okay. So that's the tool number 3. Yes, that was the tool number 3. That's the histogram. Yeah. Histogram and the bonus of like plotting two variables on one graph, okay? And the final tool is the scatter plot. That's, you do it like this. Yeah. Let's say we want to find a relationship between age again and the credit amount. So the best tool to try to understand this relationship is a scatter plot. So X equals H and Y equals credit amount. That's How cool is that? Yeah, beautiful. Some kind of hedgehog. But that's not obviously a scatter plot. Scatter plot, you have to add the parameter kind. Scatter. Scatter. And here is you have plotted the all your data points in a, like in coordinates of two variables of age and the create amount. And sometimes it's very useful because you can immediately spot the pattern. Something like this, for example, you could find that your data is like if one goes up, then the second go up too. So kind of like this, yes, the line. Linear relationship, you see, but here it's difficult to see some any relationship. Yes, so and what's the answer here? Yes, how to find the relationship? Come back to pivot table, and to build a pivot table by age, we have to bin it at first. Yes, so I will use age bin equals. PD cut, here is DFH, and here let's have a 10H categories. Now pivot table, let's copy this stuff, yeah, because we only have to change the one variable, and here is H bin. Bam. And now I can analyze it. So maybe for 10 is like too much here. Yeah, we can go without plotting a graph, we could look at five categories here. And I could see just using my eyes that here is, we have most observations here. Let's divide it, I don't know, by, let's use cookup here to have an equal groups. Again, I could barely see any pattern using my eyes. Let's plot this graph. Where is it? But I should save this table to T. Groups here should be equal, by the way, but they are not. H bin, to cut, H bin. The groups are discrete because, and that's why they are not perfectly equal, you see. So here there is some trace of some upside down parabola, you see. Maybe we should go with, I don't know, maybe. Let's return to a cut. Like this. But here again, the groups is too unequal. And by the way, to rotate the labels, you could use rot. Rot equals 90. Doesn't work. 45. I can't control it. I don't know why. Okay. So here is the same pattern again, some kind of upside down parabola. So when the people is young, they have like, they tend to have lower amounts, yes, then a little bit more high, and then they goes to a minimum, okay. So, and that's the four tools for data analysis. Let me list them again. The first one is a pivot table. And by the way, never use Python comments, okay? Because no one reads them. First one, pivot table. histogram. No, the second one is plot, hist, and scatter. So that's for like tools for doing all data analysis. You don't need anything, believe me. With these tools, you can complete whatever you want. Pivot table plus cut, yeah. Plot, it's just a small addition. Plot plus bar, hist plus box plot. And for scatter, I don't know, nothing. Scatter has no friends. It stands alone, okay? That's it, guys. See you, have fun.